Hello everyone, myself Preeti Godha, and today I am going to start chapter number 1, that is about input and output devices. So welcome you all to the St. Thomas High Secondary School, Barnagar. And today we are going to start our first chapter, that is about input and output devices. So the first topic is computer. Do you know what is computer? Had you seen this picture? Yes, we are very familiar with this device. We had seen in our computer lab the computers which we are using in our daily life. What is this computer? The computer is an electronic device that processes a raw data and instructions provided by the user to get meaningful results as output. That means whatever the instructions we are giving to the computer convert it into the meaningful results, which is called as output. We had seen we are giving, suppose that if we want to add two numbers like 3 and 5, then which app we will use? We will use calculator in our computer. Okay, and we are entering the two numbers, that is 3 and 5. This 3 and 5 are known as input. But when we are pressing the plus between 3 and 5, so what will be the process? The process will be adding these two numbers. Okay, and then we are getting the output called as 8. The output which we are getting is known as the meaningful result, or we can say it is the output. How we are getting this output? When we are providing the input to the computer, then only we are getting the output. So this device, we had seen our school, banks, malls, hospitals, railway stations, airports, etc. Because this device is very fast, which is working very fast, as well as the output which we are getting is also accurate. That means computer kabhi bhi koi galti nahi karta hai if we are giving the correct input. So that's why we are using these devices. The next one is hardware. You know what is the hardware? You had seen these devices. Okay, so this monitor, CPU, speakers, keyboard, mouse, and printer, all these devices are known as the hardware. Not only these devices, the other devices like CD, DVD, all these devices are also known as hardware. So what is the meaning of the hardware? Hardware means the part of the computer which can be seen and touched are called hardware. Hardware, that means jisko hum chhu sakte hain, dekh sakte hain, use hardware bolte hain. Okay, the next one is software. So what is the software? Software, that means all the applications which we are using, like first one is MS Word, MS Excel, PowerPoint, MS Access, email, Netflix, Google Documents, PDF Reader, Google Drive, all these are known as softwares which we require to install in our system. So what is the definition of the software? The instructions given to get desired results. जो हम कोई भी इनपुट देते हैं और उसके बाद जो हमें आउटपुट मिलता है तो वो किसके थ्रू मिलता है? दैट आउटपुट विल बी जनरेटेड थ्रू सॉफ्टवेयर्स. वी कैन ओनली फील दिस सॉफ्टवेयर, वी कैन नॉट इवन टच देम. ओके, सो द एग्जांपल्स लाइक मूवीज, इफ यू वांट टू एंजॉय द म्यूजिक देन वी वांट टू ओपन द विंडोज मीडिया प्लेयर टू एंजॉय द म्यूजिक. सो फॉर दैट ऑल द सॉफ्टवेयर्स आर रिक्वायर्ड इन अवर सिस्टम. With the help of the softwares and the hardwares, the computer is working. अगर hardware नहीं होगा, सिर्फ software होंगे, तब भी हम work नहीं कर पाएंगे. और सिर्फ software होंगे, hardware नहीं होगा, तब भी हम work नहीं कर पाएंगे. So that means hardware and software both are the necessary things for the computer. So let us start the topic input devices. What are the input devices and what it means? So when we are giving something to the computer, that is called as input. When we are processing something, that is called as the process. And the output which is generated by the computer is called as output. So these terms is known as IPO cycle. Okay, I stands for input, P stands for process, and O stands for output. So working on the computer depends on the basic principle called as input, process, and output, IPO cycle. What is the meaning of the word input? When we are entering something, when we are entering data into the computer, that is called as input. When we are processing something, that is called as process. Output, output means to show the result after processing the entered data. That means output is called as the result which we are getting from the computer. Okay, so output, that means when we are giving something to the computer, then the result which we are getting, that is called as output. So some input devices which we are going to study in our topic. The first input device is called as keyboard. Keyboard is the most common input device. Okay, this is the keyboard. Here the letters are not there. So just see that the colors, different colors which is given on the keys. The maximum keys in the keyboard is the alphanumeric keys, which is in the yellow color. That keys are also known as typing keys. Okay, yellow color is known as typing keys and the alphanumeric keys. The next one is control keys, which is in the pink color. Control keys, all these keys are known as the control keys. Under the control keys, we are getting Windows button, Alt button, Control button. Then we are getting escape key. All these are known as the control keys. Then function keys, F1 to F12, which is given in the top of the keyboard, are known as function keys. The navigation keys. Under the navigation keys, we are getting page up, page down. Then all the arrow buttons, home button, delete button. Then numeric keys. Numeric keys, which is given in the blue color on the right side of the keyboard. All these are known as numeric keys. Then indicator keys, which we have three lights at the top of the keyboard under the brown color, that is known as the indicator keys. So what is the keyboard? First of all, let us see the keyboard. This is the most common input device. This device is used for instructing. That means we can instruct the computer and typing the data into the computer. Mainly we are using the keyboard for typing the data and giving the instructions to the computer. The keys can be divided into the different groups based on their functions. As I already told, we have six different type of the keys. That are control keys, function keys, typing and the alphanumeric keys, navigation keys, numeric keys, and indicator lights. So have a detailed description about these different types of the keys of the keyboard. The first one is typing keys, which is also called as alphanumeric keys. All these keys which you are seeing on the screen are known as alphanumeric keys. Okay, so what are the alphanumeric keys? These keys include alphabet keys, punctuation keys, special symbols, number keys, shift, caps lock, backspace, tab, and the space bar. So are you getting this? This is the space bar. This is known as the space bar. Then backspace key. This is known as the backspace key. Tab. This is known as the tab key. All these are the number keys. All this 1, 2, 0. All these are known as the number keys. Then the special symbols, like we are getting this asterisk symbol, underscore symbol, ampersand, hash, at the rate, exclamation mark. All these are known as the special keys. Then punctuation keys, semicolon, comma. All these are known as the punctuation keys. And the rest, A to Z keys, are known as alphabet keys. So the combination of all these keys, like alphabet keys, punctuation keys, special symbols, number keys, shift, caps lock, backspace, tab, and the space bar keys, are known as alphanumeric keys. The next type of the keys available in the keyboard is numeric keys. So numeric keys, can you see here, which we are getting on the right side of the keyboard? All these numbers starting from 0 to 9 is known as numeric keys, including some operators. The numeric keypad is used for entering numbers and are similar to the calculator. These are placed on the right side of the keyboard. Where it is available? It is available on the right side of the keyboard. These keys are grouped from 0 to 9 numbers. Kahan se kahan tak number hote hain? 0 to 9. It also has decimal point. Ye decimal point hai. And arithmetic operators like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These are known as the arithmetic operators. Plus, minus, multiply, divide. All these are known as the arithmetic operator. So this keypad is known as numeric keypad. The next type of the keys available in the keyboard is navigation keys. We had seen these keys in our keyboard. These are known as arrow keys. Left arrow, bottom arrow, right arrow, upper arrow. And these keys are known as insert key, home key, page up, page down, and delete keys. Navigation keys are used for moving around in documents and editing text. Agar hame document mein kahin bhi idhar udhar jana hai, upside, downside, left side, ya right side. So we are using these keys. They include arrow key. These are known as the arrow keys. Home key and key. Page up, page down. Delete button and insert button. These all keys are known as navigation keys. Navigation means yahi hota hai ki we can move here and there in the documents. So all these keys are used to move in the document. The next key is control keys. Control, that means through which we can control our system, control our files. That keys are known as control keys. So we have escape key, control key, Windows key, and Alt key to control the document or to control our system. So these keys are used alone or in the combination of the other keys to perform certain actions. That means we can use these keys as the individual keys, or we can use these keys with the other keys. These control keys are Control, Alt, Windows logo key, and Escape key. These are the four control keys. The next key is indicator keys. Indicator, that means jo hame indicate karta hai, that are known as indicator keys. We had seen these keys in the top of our keyboard. Three different lights we are getting on the top of the keyboard. This is known as the indicator keys. These keys get activated when we are using num lock, caps lock, and scroll lock. These three type of the lights, these three lights we are getting on the top of the keyboard, which is called as indicator keys or the status keys. The next keys is function keys. With the help of these functional keys, we can control or we can perform certain specific actions. These keys are from F1 to F12. These keys are known as functional keys. These keys can perform certain specific actions, which they are labeled as F1, F2, up to F12. The functionality of these keys differ from the program to program. Her program ke andar inka kuch ek alag meaning hota hai. So that means these keys have their own specific functions, which varies from program to program. So all the keys which we studied are very clear to you. The last topic which we are studying is about important keys of the keyboard, which are the different keys which we are using in our the keyboard. First one is enter key, which is used to execute an instruction. Caps lock key, to write the letters in capital letter. कैपिटल लेटर में लिखने के लिए हम कैप्स लॉक की को ऑन करते हैं और स्मॉल लेटर में लिखने के लिए कैप्स लॉक की को ऑफ करते हैं. द नेक्स्ट वन इज शिफ्ट की. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट द अपर सिम्बॉल्स दैट मीन्स कैपिटल ए, कैपिटल बी, कैपिटल सी लिखना है और कैप्स लॉक ऑफ है तो वी आर यूजिंग शिफ्ट की टू राइट इन कैपिटल लेटर्स. बैकस्पेस की. बैकस्पेस की दैट मीन्स वी वॉन्ट टू इरेज द कैरेक्टर फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट साइड टू इट्स लेफ्ट साइड. दैट मीन्स एक कैरेक्टर लेफ्ट साइड से इरेज होगा. दैट मीन्स कर्सर के लेफ्ट साइड से. कर्सर जहाँ ब्लिंक कर रहा है कर्सर का लेफ्ट साइड से एक कैरेक्टर इरेज होगा. और डिलीट की. कर्सर से राइट साइड में कैरेक्टर्स डिलीट होंगे. एस्केप की. टू कैंसिल ए कमांड. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कम आउट फ्रॉम एनी ऑफ द कमांड एनी ऑफ द पेज देन वी आर प्रेसिंग एस्केप की. इंसर्ट की. टू इंसर्ट द कैरेक्टर एट द करंट कर्सर पोजिशन. जहाँ पर कर्सर की पोजिशन है वहाँ कुछ आकर हमें इंसर्ट करना है तो वी आर यूजिंग इंसर्ट की. स्पेस बार की. टू मूव द कर्सर वन स्टेप फॉरवर्ड. कंट्रोल एंड अल्ट की. दे आर यूज विद द अदर कीज. कंट्रोल और अल्ट की को किसी कॉम्बिनेशन के साथ में हम यूज कर सकते हैं. नम लॉक की. इफ द नम लॉक की इज ऑफ देन वी कैन नॉट प्रेस एनी ऑफ द नंबर्स फ्रॉम द न्यूमेरिक कीबोर्ड. दैट मीन्स नम लॉक की इज यूज टू एक्टिवेट द न्यूमेरिक कीज. न्यूमेरिक कीज को एक्टिवेट करने के लिए हम कौन सी कीज यूज करते हैं? नम लॉक की. द नेक्स्ट वन इज होम की. होम की दैट मीन्स इट मूव्स द कर्सर एट द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द पेज. पेज के स्टार्टिंग में होम पेज पे ले जाता है. स्टार्टिंग पेज पे ले जाता है होम की. और एंड की इसी का अपोजिट काम करता है. टू मूव द कर्सर एट द एंड ऑफ द पेज. पेज के लास्ट में लेके आ जाता है. देन पेज अप की. टू मूव वन पेज अप. एक पेज को राइट अपसाइड मूव करता है. और पेज डाउन की. टू मूव्स द पेज वन पेज डाउन. टैब की. टैब की टू डू मल्टीपल स्पेस बिटवीन टू वर्ड्स इन अ डॉक्यूमेंट. अगर हमें किसी लेटर्स के बीच में बहुत ज्यादा स्पेस देनी है तो वी आर यूजिंग टैब की टू गिव द मल्टीपल स्पेस. एरो कीज. टू मूव द कर्सर इन द टॉप डायरेक्शन, बॉटम डायरेक्शन, लेफ्ट राइट डायरेक्शंस इन अ डॉक्यूमेंट. फंक्शन कीज. वी नो वी हैव 12 फंक्शन कीज दैट इज फ्रॉम F1 टू F12. सो दीज कीज आर नंबर 12. दिस आर यूज्ड फॉर स्पेशल फंक्शंस. हर प्रोग्राम में अपने अपने फंक्शंस होते हैं. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द वन इनपुट डिवाइस. अभी हमने इस वीडियो में सिर्फ एक इनपुट डिवाइस के बारे में डिस्कशन किया है दैट इज कीबोर्ड. वी हैड द डिटेल्ड डिस्कशन अबाउट द कीबोर्ड इन दिस वीडियो. द कीबोर्ड इज नोन एज द इनपुट डिवाइस. ओके सो वन इनपुट डिवाइस वी स्टडीड इन दिस वीडियो. आई होप दिस वीडियो इज क्लियर टू यू. सो थैंक यू एवरीवन फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. एंड इफ यू हैव any of the doubt then you can contact me. Thank you everyone.